Maybe I'm just cheap like that. I don't know. The colors go together with the season. Well, you kind of hear those horror stories, you know? Well, hello, my beauties, and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 43 and from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today is another Style Tone unboxing. First, let me tell you a little bit about Style Tone. It's basically a Dutch subscription box. You have your Ipsy bag and your, you know, all that goodness, BoxyCharm and all that kind of thing. We have a few here as well. I just chose the Style Tone. The Style Tone box is a monthly subscription box, and if you pay per month, you have the most expensive box actually, and that's €12.50 per month. And that's just, you know, everyone gets the same, but I pay per month instead of per 3 months or half a year or year even. I will leave the website down below. I have the Style Tone box. It looks like this. It looks like this. It's just a box, and it should fit in the mail slot, but usually it doesn't. You get 5 products every month in the box. They are always cruelty free. They also try to do mostly vegan products, so that's always good to know. And you know, it's all kinds of brands, so it's not just Dutch brands, it's from all over basically. So yeah, and they're especially for me brands that I have never heard of, so that is good. And from what I saw there, what I have received in the boxes, it's mostly more focused on indie brands instead of the very, very big mainstream brands like, you know, L'Oreal and all that goodness. So, okay, usually what I do, I have 2 parts to my video. I tell you obviously about the new stuff that I got in the box and show you, and if I want to apply it, I apply it, and I also tell you if last month's box was worth it, and well, kind of give you a review on the products from last month's box as well. I do peek in the boxes, so what I did is I grabbed the booklet from the box and I just, you know, looked through it to see, well, how I should appear on camera basically. So yeah, that's what I did today as well. So I only primed my face, skincare and sunscreen obviously. Then I primed my face. I was going to put on foundation, but I decided against it, and I will let you know a little bit why in a minute. First, let me go over last month's box. So I have here the booklet from February. Let's see what we had again. Oh yeah, we had the Yoga highlighter. This is cruelty free and vegan. The stuff smells like paint putty. Is that paint putty? No, it's not really paint putty. I don't know. It's that wall putty, you know? That's what it smells like. I have not used this a lot, actually, because it's just not blinding enough for me. It's not a bad product, but it's just not blinding enough for me. And I keep forgetting to grab for it, to be quite honest with you. So yeah, again, it's not a bad product. It retails for €14.95. Do I think it's worth it? Maybe, I don't know. I haven't used it enough for that. So yeah, not bad. I just don't grab for it. Okay, the next product was from Fix and Rouge, and it was their light reflective brightening primer and illuminator. It retails for a whopping €35. It's cruelty free and vegan. I like this. What I do with this, I tend to mix it in with foundations, and especially foundations that I need to powder, if that makes any sense. So some foundations, they just don't want to dry down completely. If I mix this in, they kind of do. It's pretty. I get a pretty sheen overall. I don't know if you can see it, more of a, I don't know what it is. It's not really pinky or champagne-y. I don't know if you can see it, but it gives a nice glow to the skin. I don't use it often, but it's nice. Is it worth €35? I don't think so, but who am I to judge? I don't know if it particularly hydrates, but it doesn't dry out my skin. My skin doesn't feel tight if I use it, so that's good. Again, I don't think it's worth €35, but maybe I'm just cheap like that. I don't know. And that's also because my favorite primer is this one from Catrice. You know, that is 5 euros or something like that. 4 or 5 euros. So, yeah. Next, we had nail polish. Where did I put it? Here. Oh, here. From Avril Cosmetics. It retails for 3 euros. It's cruelty-free and vegan. I like this. I really like... I don't have it on now. I really like the color. It's not particularly long-lasting, but then again... Nothing is for me unless I use a gel layer on top or something like that. But yeah, I think it's a very pretty color, and 3 euros is a very, very nice price for this. So I highly recommend that nail polish. The next thing that I have is this one from Bella Pierre. It's the metallic lip cream. I used it in the video. I haven't grabbed it after that though. It's just because I don't grab these types of lipsticks often. But it is pretty. It's comfortable. I also used it on my eye. I did not have a problem. It stayed all day. No burning, no itching, no nothing. So it's very pretty. It smells like sweets. So it smells good. It's very pretty, but again, I just don't grab it often. This retails for a whopping 20 euros. And you know, I do know that you get a lot, but still, I don't know. So is it worth 20 euros? Well, not to me, personally. Just so you know. The last thing I had was Lord & Barry. Oh yeah, the mascara that I forgot to use. So here it is. It's not a bad mascara. You know, it kind of reminds me of the Batgirl Bang and of my favorite, the one from Catrice. It's not a bad mascara. Is it worth €23? Well, not in my opinion, because my favorite is the one from Catrice, which retails for between €4 and €5. So, yeah. And that one is waterproof and this one isn't. But it is a nice mascara. Do I think it is worth the €12.50? Yes, I do. Would I pay the retail price for these products? No. No. But just, you know, these, yeah, are worth €12.50 for me. I would not buy one of these just because I don't gravitate towards it. I don't gravitate towards anything like this either, but I'm glad I have it and I think it's really nice. So then I would buy... things like this, and that would be worth €12.50 for me. So yeah, I think that the box from last month is worth it. Let's go to this month, shall we? I like the aesthetics. It gives me spring vibes. This is the March box, and it says a colorful life. Well, let's debate that, shall we? Oh, they redid their webshop. Oh, so that's good. So basically, all the stuff you get in the box, you should be able to order through the Styletone website as well. Just so you know. So, let me move you to the side. So, here I have the box. Let's open the box. And this is what it looks like inside. It says here, enjoy beautiful. And then you get stuff in bubble wrap. So, let me get it out. Beautiful things inside. It says, why is it always such a mess here? Okay, so this is also number one, which is from Coco Star. It's a hand moisturizing pack and Korean skincare. It retails usually for €3.95. You need to leave it on for about 20 minutes. And what I actually heard, I think it was on one, I think Samantha March said it. No. Glitter Fallout said it. She also does unboxings, not Dutch ones, but American ones. And she got a Tatcha mask and that one really dripped. Then one of her subscribers said to her that you could reuse something like that. I watched that video and thank you so much, subscriber from Glitter Fallout, because I do that now too. So if you get a sheet mask or eye sheet masks, because you have them for underneath your eyes as well, if they are the papery kind, you can reuse them. You always get more goopy product than you use. So what I do now is I just have a glass jar, and if I use a sheet mask, I get the sheet mask out first, then I pour whatever is left in the sachet into the glass bowl, see how much it is. Sometimes if the sheet mask is really, really wet, I kind of squeeze it out a little bit so that I still have a wet sheet mask, but that I also can reuse it a second time. Then if the sheet mask is on my face and it's dry, I put it in a glass jar so it can soak up the product again. Then I can use it twice. So yeah, that's what I want to do with this as well. So I'm actually, it says moisturizing and soothing. I'm actually quite interested in this. So yeah, I will let you know in next month's unboxing how I liked it and if I could indeed use it twice or maybe even more than twice. Number two is from Pays and it's an eyeshadow trio. It retails for 18 euros. So this is what it looks like and it looks really fun. What kind of vibes do you get? You know, summery vibes, maybe a green and a red and an orange, you know? Cardboard packaging, so that's nice. Then you open her up. It does not come with a plastic sheet, which for 18 euros, I kind of expect. It does close with a magnet, so that's good. It does not have, oh, it's made in Poland. It does not really have ingredients on the back. So, yeah, I'm kind of guessing I'm missing a sleeve here, you know? But okay, but yeah, these are the colors. So yeah, I am actually not sure if I will use this, to be honest with you. They are not really shimmers. They're a cross between a shimmer and a satin. I don't know if I will use this. So I actually don't really want to touch it either because if I swatch it, I feel like I cannot give it away in a giveaway, you know, I cannot put it in my giveaway pile. But yeah, the colors go together with the season. Well, not really. I can safely say that I would not pay 18 euros for this. And you know I will never grab it after this video. So I'm not going to use it. I'm going to put it aside. I'm going to leave it, put it aside and put it in my giveaway pile. So yeah, it's just not for me. Next we have from So Susan, a Dreammaker highlighting cream. It's new and it retails for 29 euros. It's cruelty free and vegan. This is the thingy. It's an oil free highlighter with rainbow particles. And oh yeah, and that is why I didn't put my foundation on, because you can also mix it with your foundation or your moisturizer for an overall glow. So yeah, it's very tiny and I'm actually quite excited to try this. Oh, so let's see, taking a tiny bit. Well, hello. Let's get the beauty blender. Let's get a little bit on the back of my hand. And I actually like the fact that it is such a tiny nozzle. I'm going to kind of do that. I don't know if this works though. I don't think so. Well, maybe it does. I think I'm getting a glow. Am I getting a glow, people? Let's try mixing it in with my foundation. So I have here the Primark Double Coverage Foundation, my favorite. I have here something like that. Let's mix it up. Let's see what it does. So let me get a little bit of my foundation, a little bit of this stuff. Lord, I'm going to glow like a ball, like, oh, I don't know. Let me get a Q-tip to mix it. And then kind of go to town with it, basically. I think I need to work quickly, though, because usually if I mix anything in with my foundation, it kind of changes the way that it sets, you know, the set time, if that makes any sense. Is it me or is it lightening my foundation? Maybe I kind of tanned a little bit because we had some nice days. Could be, I don't know. Oh, I love this foundation so much. I need to go to Primark and see if they have other shades because I need more shades. I need backups, people. Okay, so let's kind of put this underneath my eyes. Well, I have a review on this foundation on my channel, by the way. I do think that I have reflection on my face. And I kind of want to go to town with it, you know? So I'm let's put a little bit on my fingers. So I have some here. Let's kind of see if I can kind of highlight my face with it. I don't know if I need to maybe do that, you know? I don't particularly see that I am blinding to the gods, but I do think it's pretty. Oh, wait, I see the reflection in my camera. I'm not particularly hating this product. I think it's pretty. No, I need to get the right cap, not the one from the glue. I think that this is something that I can grab when I'm not doing a real foundation day. So when I'm just, you know, putting on my primer and a bit of concealer. And it appears to have more of a sheen than the one from Yoga Yoga, the pot. I like also the fact that this is in a tube and not in a pot. Okay, let's put on a little bit of concealer. I also need to prime my eyelids. Because, yeah, I do want to do my eyes. That's going to be... because I'm not going to use this eyeshadow palette. I'm going to do my eyeshadow off camera. Okay, I'm going to wait with my brows because I know I have another cream product. Anyway, let's go to the next product that I have, which is from Bang Beauty. And it is their Dolce Pink Cream. And it retails for 22 euros. I am actually hoping that this is better quality than their eyeliner. Because I'm not impressed by their eyeliner. But this is a cream pot. And you can use it for cheeks, eyes, and lips. Okay, so here it is. But let me get a brush. Let me do that. So I have a brush that does not want to pick up anything, really. Oh, here, yes. Okay, so I have a bit here. Let's see. It's pretty though. Pretty subtle, but pretty. And I actually have been wanting to kind of get a little bit more into cream products, blushes and all that goodness, because I think it will be fun. I just don't like the fact that I almost cannot get anything on my brush. Maybe it's the wrong brush, I don't know. It shouldn't be, because it's just a synthetic brush, so it should be good. Okay, so I cleaned my lips from the concealer and stuff. Let me put it on my lips. Yeah, I'm not a fan of that. It almost looks like I have nothing here. And I'm kind of annoyed by that. I think it's pretty, but yeah, no, it's not. You know, for 22 euros, I expect something that is a bit more pigmented, to be honest. So far, what I've tried from Bang Beauty, I'm not really that impressed. Let me at least set my under eyes, because they are creasing like crazy. And then let me kind of lightly set the rest as well. Okay, so powder products are on. I did add a little bit of blush, highlighter and bronzer. Everything will be listed down below that I put on my face besides what I have in the box. And I have one item left, which is from Quick Max, and it is an eyelash serum. It gives you the, let me see, it should give you results within 1 to 6 weeks. But I, you know, the trouble is with a lot of this stuff, you kind of hear those horror stories, you know? But you know what I don't get? If I read the ingredients here, it's water and then L-arginine, hyaluronic acid, vitamin A, D-alpha tocopherol and urea A. What's the ingredient that makes your lashes grow then? I don't know. But what I can do, because I had a shaving accident. Yes. I think I'm going to try this on my eyebrows first. Just to see how my skin reacts to it. Because I'm kind of afraid to put it on my eye, you know? Does that make any sense? So yeah. Let me open it up. So here it is. It's not big. That's what she said. Eyelash growth enhancer. It's a brush. I'm kind of scared. I'm not going to put it on now because I have makeup on anyway. And yeah, I will let you know next month, basically, if it has helped. So yeah, what I'm going to do now is the rest of my face. Eyeshadow, basically. That's going to be a separate video, though. But I will be back in just a second. You will see, well, my whole glorious me. And then I will, well, kind of discuss if I think this month's box is worth it and how I kind of feel about the stuff so far. So hold on tight. So my face is on and yeah, I still have my backdrop up from my look. It's just I didn't feel like taking it away actually. The look I have on my face, I filmed. It is one of the looks with the Dream with a Vision eyeshadow palette from Obsession. It's actually the first look. I don't know how many I will film. I want to film 5 at least, but we will see. And yeah, in case you are wondering, well, you're probably not wondering, I'm also practicing my voiceover. So that will be my first real looks video with voiceovers. So yeah. Okay, but let's go over what I think of the box, shall we? Let's get the booklet. The hand mask I have not used, obviously, so I will let you know next month. But I don't think that €3.95 is a bad price for it. And the So Susan highlighting cream. Well, first off, for €29, no. For me personally, I have to say though that my face looks luminous. I don't particularly go for that look all over. So I do think that if you have, I don't know, a matte foundation and you want it to make it more luminous, you can mix this one in. The foundation I have on is not particularly matte. It is more of a, I don't know, satiny finish. It says matte, but it's not really a matte. I do have to say though that it is kind of breaking up my foundation. Now I have trouble skin, and what do I mean with trouble skin? My trouble skin just means that I have a problem with foundation sticking to my face here, there. And if I use products that are not really compatible with my skin, it tends to break up here really, really fast. So that is what I mean with problem skin for me. Okay, that said, I know how this foundation works. I know how it works in combination with the concealer I have on and all that goodness, because the products that I used, with the exception of this one, are all products that I use more often. I mixed this one in and it went underneath my eye as well. And I don't know if you can see what the concealer is doing. Maybe if I zoom you in. But it is kind of not looking so nice. And the only thing I did differently than normal is I used this mixed in. So I just need to use it separate from my foundation, I think. Or maybe not underneath my eye. Or, you know, I need to play with it a little bit more. That said, again, for €29, I kind of expect it to, well, just, you know, slap on your face and work. Is that too much to ask? I don't know, people. I don't use these things a lot. I do have to say, if I mix this one in with my foundation, I don't have any weird breaking up, and it actually helps to kind of stick to my skin more. But then again, this is also a primer, so it could be that as well. I need to play with it a little bit more. Do I think it's worth €29? I would say no, but I'm also not a person who uses this a lot, so I don't have a lot of experience with something like this. You know, if you do, let me know. If you have this, let me know as well. And let me know how you use it. Okay. So I'm just going to use it as well. Just on top. Oh yeah, I did that as well, didn't I? Just on top. Maybe I need to put it here instead of here. I'm going to play with it a little bit more. The next thing is from Bang Beauty. Is the Dolce Pink Cream. Well, first off, if I'm paying €22 for a product and it looks like this, I expect the lid to be metal, not plastic. I don't mind a plastic lid, but then, I don't know, make it black or make it gray or, you know, make it like this, the frosting. Make it look like that, not like metal, because that's just cheap, you know? They also did that with their eyeliner and it's not really a good eyeliner in my opinion either. The packaging is just very, very cheap. I can kind of get on board with cheap packaging if then the product that is inside is really blowing me away. But it's not either that either. You know, this, it's pretty on the skin. I do, however, need to build it up quite a lot. And I'm not particularly dark. You know, I'm not very, very fair. I'm light. I'm not, or is light, I think fair is lighter than light. I don't know, you know. If you are deeper than me, this will not show up on you, or at least this color will not show up on you. And first impression is just, it's not pigmented enough. You know, if I dip my brush in and I tap it out, I should have more color than just this. It could also, of course, be the color, that this color is just really light. It does look really, really pretty. It's just not it. You know, maybe I can use it as an eyeshadow with a different brush. I can try that. For my lips, it's not going to work. I can tap it over here. Maybe that's pretty. So let me try that. It doesn't really do anything. You know, I don't see any sparkle. It just, I don't know. I think it's kind of a dud. High pigmentation, no. But yeah, I'm going to play with this some more as well. You know, maybe just when I don't wear foundation, put this on my cheeks. Maybe it's better then, I don't know. But for €22, I would have expected more. And I had the same feeling with the eyeliner as well. So yeah, if you have anything from Bang Beauty, let me know how you like it. The last thing is from Quick Max. It's the eyelash serum. I am going to use it first on my eyebrows to see what it does there. So yeah, it's quite liquidy and I'm actually quite scared of it. But I am going to try it and I will let you know next month. So that is it for my Styletone unboxing. Do you have the Styletone? Let me know down below. Let me know if you like the products. Maybe you got something different than me. I don't think so, but you know, maybe you got some different colors. Let me know down below. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. Oh yeah, and if you have any of the products that I got in my box, let me know down below as well. And maybe, you know, give me some tips and tricks on how to use some of the products. I will list my playlist in my description box. And yeah, I think, oh yeah, and I will also link my first impression and review, because that's the same video, with this palette from Obsession down as well, because it went up yesterday. So yeah, again, if you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to sign off. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening, and I hope to see you again soon, tomorrow. Yeah, because I have a lot of videos to get out. So tomorrow will be another one. Bye guys.